What's like the biggest change that you did for a client where like, you know, they had a huge list? Like, what was the biggest where we sent one email and we made 100 grand? Do you have any stories like that where they weren't even sending campaigns? Which the difference for people who don't know would be, you know, flows are the automated sequences that happen as people do things. And then campaigns are, hey, we're having a sale today, it ends tonight, where you do an actual send in real time to everyone. So what was like the biggest thing you did where they had a million people and they weren't even sending and you sent one email and made, you know, $500,000? I don't know.
I don't have such a dramatic story about that, but I have two other stories which in the same kind of category. So first, I was eager to explain to the client that to send one campaign to everybody is not a good strategy. You need to segment. So we send the same campaign twice to the two different segments. One segment was 100,000 subscribers. And second segment was 10,000 subscribers. So 10 times smaller, 10,000, 100,000, 10,000. So the 10,000 generated close to $1,000. The second segment, which is, was hyper segmented, 10,000, generated close to 17,000.
17,000?
Yes. So
Oh, wow.
what is, like, if you do math, what is a return on investment? So it was the power of segmentation. So logically it doesn't make sense because, like, if you send it to everybody, it should be better, but it's not, because you're hurting your deliverability if you're sending to everybody and they don't care much about what you are sending in those email. So this is story number one. And story number two, client had 200 subscribers. And we didn't make them all, like, a lot of money when we started, but we saved them a lot. So they had 150,000 bots.
150,000 or 150 out of 200?
No. 150. So they had 200,000 total subscribers. 150,000 were 1,000 were bots.
Oh my gosh.
And they were
Which is really
constantly,
dangerous.
yes.
There's spam traps. There's all the, I mean, you can, if you start sending to those, then you get put in jail basically for email, right?
Yeah, and the thing is, I don't think it was such a big deal here in the US because it was Russian bots. So what they were doing, instead of the first name, they were inserting some text with the link. So those were real emails, and they were receiving in their inbox subject line with the link, so they are able to click. But they were using this client's email, like server, to send out those emails. So it was kind of, from spam perspective, it was genius, but for the client, it was terrible.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Those are both great stories.